In your talk in 2015, you spoke about this model of the brain that you called Mr. Potato Head. And I'd like you to recap that model, because I think it really paves the way nicely for what's to come.
Yeah. Something I've always been interested in is the brain is locked in silence and darkness inside the skull, and all that you have in there are spikes. These are electrical spikes that are these chemicals. And if I were to show you a part of the brain with some magical microscope where you could see all these spikes, I said, hey, Chris, is that the visual part of the brain or auditory or touch? You couldn't tell me. I couldn't tell you, because it's all the same. It looks the same everywhere in the brain. And so the part that got me interested is, yeah, how does the system create the colors and the light and the smells and the touch and all that stuff, given that it's really just zeros and ones going on in there. So anyway, I got interested in the senses, and all these things, like these two spheres in your head are just translating photons into spikes, and your ears are translating air compression waves into spikes and mixtures of molecules. And so anyway, the model I ended up proposing is this potato head model, which is that it doesn't matter how you get information in there, the brain will figure out what to do with it, because that's what it's really good at doing. Essentially, it's a all-purpose compute device, and whatever spikes it's getting, it says, oh, that's relevant for my behavior. I can do something with that. And so the potato head model is simply that you can switch the things around and maybe even build completely new senses and plug them in anywhere, and it doesn't matter.